So students, today we are going to start with the next topic of the chapter, effect of catalyst on the rate of the reaction. We have seen two factors which affect the rate of the reaction. One is concentration of the reactant, the other one was temperature, how it affects the rate of the reaction. Now the third factor, that is the catalyst, how it affects the rate of the reaction. So we have seen the graph of how the activation energy affects the formation of the products. So this is the potential energy. And we call this graph as the energy profile diagram. In this is the condition or the state of energy of the reactant. Suppose the reactant is A and B, and it is giving the intermediate, and this is the energy of the intermediate, and it will be equal to the threshold energy. This value is the threshold energy. And then this is the energy of products. So we have studied this graph in the previous part of the chapter, that is the effect of temperature on the rate of the reaction. So the reactants, they combine to form an intermediate which is having much higher energy as compared to that of the reactants. Again the intermediate then decomposes to give the product, and the products may have energy equal less or more than that of the reactant. If they have less energy than that of the reactant, it will be an exothermic reaction, and if the energy of the products is more, then it will be an endothermic reaction. So this was just a recapitulation of the previous part of the chapter, because now what we are going to see is the catalyst, effect of catalyst on the rate of the reaction. So children, if you remember, we discussed in the temperature dependence one reaction, that is decomposition of potassium chlorate into potassium chloride and oxygen gas. And we had seen like at how different temperatures the time taken changes for this reaction. Also one aspect of this same reaction is, if the reaction takes place in the presence of manganese dioxide, then the reaction becomes faster. So MnO2 acts as a catalyst for this reaction. It means that due to the presence of MnO2, the reaction becomes faster. Now why does the reaction becomes faster? So catalyst, it offers a surface for the reactant and the product to combine together. So whatever reactants are there, the catalyst surface will hold on to those reactants. At a quite lower energy, it will form the intermediate by holding on the reactant molecules on the surface. And once they get held on the surface, they can easily react at even a lower energy as compared to the threshold energy which is required for the intermediate to form. Getting it? If suppose the molecules are moving randomly and they have to react, then more activation energy will be required for them to collide and form the intermediate. But if they are held on the surface of the catalyst, then less energy will be required for them to react. So that is what the catalyst is doing. What it is doing? It is holding on to the reactant molecules. So this will result into the lessening of the threshold energy, or we can say that the reactants will require a less activation energy. This value is the activation energy. So the activation energy will get lowered in the presence of a catalyst. Getting it? How it will get lowered? Why? Because the catalyst will hold the reactant molecules on its surface, thereby making the reactant molecules fixed on the surface. So they will require less energy to react with each other or to form the intermediate in order to get converted into the products. So what does the catalyst do? It provides an alternative path. This is the path without catalyst, means it will be of a higher activation energy, and this is a path which is of a lower activation energy. So this graph is in the presence of a catalyst. So in the presence of a catalyst, the reaction will take place faster. Why? Because the activation energy of the reaction becomes less, it gets lowered. So activation energy, that is EA, becomes less in presence of a catalyst. Another important thing to remember is delta G. Delta G is the Gibbs free energy change. Gibbs free energy decides the spontaneity of the reaction. So catalyst will not affect, delta G is not affected by the presence of a catalyst. What does it mean? It means that a spontaneous reaction will remain spontaneous and a non-spontaneous reaction will not become spontaneous in the presence of a catalyst. A catalyst cannot make a non-spontaneous reaction to happen. Only it can catalyze a spontaneous reaction. So delta G will not get affected. One more aspect of a chemical reaction is the equilibrium constant, Kc. So equilibrium constant also will not get affected due to the presence of a catalyst. What does equilibrium constant determine? It determines to how much extent the reaction will go in the forward or backward direction. Means indirectly mean to say that how much of the product will form. More product will form or more of the reactant will remain in the reaction, that will be decided by the equilibrium constant Kc. So the catalyst also does not affect the value of equilibrium constant Kc. Whatever amount of product will form, that much is only going to form. Only the time taken to reach the equilibrium state will become less. Means the equilibrium state will be reached very fast as compared to without a catalyst. If a catalyst is there, then we will be attaining the equilibrium state for a particular reaction in less time. So that is the effect of a catalyst on the rate of the reaction. Activation energy becomes less, delta G value does not get affected, Kc does not get affected. It provides an alternative pathway for the reaction which is of a lower activation energy. And the last theory of the chapter is the collision theory. Collision theory of rate of the reaction. Earlier we have seen the temperature dependence of rate of the reaction, and that theory was given by Arrhenius. We have the mathematical expression K is equal to A into e raised to minus Ea upon RT. This expression was given by Arrhenius and it gives us the dependence of the rate or the rate constant on the temperature of at which the reaction is carried out. Now this collision theory was developed by Trotz and Lewis, and it mainly deals about the energetics, not only the energetics but at the molecular level what is happening. And this theory is based on the kinetic theory of gases. So this theory is mainly based on, as it says, collision theory. So it depends on the number of collisions taking place per second per unit volume. And whatever number of collisions are taking place per unit volume per second, that is known as the frequency, collision frequency. And the mathematical expression for this, let a reaction be there between A and B and it gives products. So then we have rate will be equal to ZAB. Means the collision frequency between reactant molecules A and B into e raised to minus Ea upon RT. And this factor, that is e raised to minus Ea upon RT, it indicates the number of molecules having activation energy, having energy equal to or more than the activation energy. Again, I am repeating, The term e raised to power minus ea upon rt indicates the number of molecules having energy equal to or more than that of the activation energy. And this expression is similar to this expression, so we can say that the collision frequency corresponds to Arrhenius factor or the frequency factor in this temperature dependence expression. Okay, now in this theory, the atoms or molecules are considered as solid spheres, and it is believed that the product can form only if collision is taking place between the molecules, and these collisions should be effective collisions, and it will also depend on the number of collisions taking place per unit volume per second. Now, for another factor which will affect is not only the collisions but the collisions in a proper manner. Means the second factor which is affecting is the orientation of molecules. Now, if the atoms or molecules are very simple, they are in the atomic form or very simple molecules, then orientation will not affect. For example, if only chlorine is there or hydrogen is there. So, hydrogen and chlorine, they are very simple molecules. They can collide in any direction anyhow and they can give the product HCl. But if it is a complex molecule, for example, if we have bromomethane, this is an organic molecule, so it will be quite complex as compared to hydrogen and chlorine atoms. And if it is reacting with OH minus ion, then we will get methanol as a product. So in this case, when there is such a complex molecule, then the orientation will matter. If suppose this OH minus ion is attacking from the backside of bromomethane, then the product CH3OH will form. But if it is attacking from the front side, like attack is from the front, then there will be no formation of the product. Means if there will be proper orientation between the molecules, then only the product will form. Otherwise, if improperly oriented molecules are colliding with each other with the same energy, with the same intensity, then also they will just bounce back and there will be no formation of product. For example, if there is a door and we have to open a door, the door has become jammed, like how it happens in the rainy season. And if we want to push open the door, then we need to require a particular strength to open that door. We can't just push the door below a particular value of intensity and the door will open. No, we need to push it with the proper intensity so that it will open. And also, if suppose the door is opening inside and I am applying force from inside to open the door. Getting it? It is opening by pushing it from out to in. And if I am applying intensity is proper, and but I am applying in the opposite direction, then will the door open? No. So in this case, proper orientation is also required along with the given strength or the given intensity to push it. So same applies here. Collision with proper activation energy is needed. Then number of collisions will also matter. And the third thing which will matter is the proper orientation of the molecules. This reaction we are going to study in Hello Alkanes, Hello Arenes chapter. It is all about the mechanism. So kinetics, it deals with the mechanism of the reaction. This is actually SN2 reaction mechanism. So if the attacking reagent attacks from the back side, then only the product will get formed. So here, when the molecule is complex, the orientation will matter a lot. Okay, so then this expression, whatever we have, it has to be converted into a proper form, and this form will become now, keeping into mind the probability. What is the probability of the molecules colliding in a particular direction? So we have to introduce one more constant, which is known as the steric factor. Steric factor, or the probability factor. So it will let it be P. So now we have to introduce, along with the collision frequency, that is Z into AB, B will be introducing P also. So that will be as good as Arrhenius factor or the frequency factor which we have seen before. So then the equation which we had earlier in terms of rate constant K, K will become equal to P into Z AB into e raised to minus EA upon RT. So this is a more appropriate equation according to the collision theory of reaction rate. So students, here we are completing this chapter, chemical kinetics. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me personally, go through the video and just solve the numericals based on this.